Thank you, communicator, Celine Pang. Wow, it's my first time at the GE here, so I think everybody from UniBank knows me already, except a few Uni job members. Now, let me ask you a question. How many of you usually write diaries or blogging, write some blogs on your website?
Facebook.
Facebook considered unofficial if you write actively. How do you feel when you're writing diaries or writing blogs?
About the day, the whole
day. Yeah. How do you feel?
Good.
Do you feel good or do you feel bad at the same time, or do you kind of curse up?
I tried to write before when I want to start writing about it, I get malu on my I'm writing about myself.
Yes, this is very true. You feel very embarrassed or humiliated by yourself. But every day by reading my writing diaries or analyzing yourself, you're constantly evaluating yourself. Now, evaluation doesn't necessarily say that if I'm speaking, I want David or Selby to evaluate me. Not necessarily. You can actually put a video camera in front. You present yourself, then you go back home. You upload it, see it yourself. Then you can truly see the true self, the positive and negative sides. You are evaluating yourself. So I believe that the best evaluator is from yourself. Doesn't matter that the speaker, they are very harsh or they say something that you feel is untrue. In the end, all of us are seeking is continuous improvement instead of we're just like stagnant right in this position. So I've been those of us to practice evaluation because we want to know that how are the things that we are lacking of, we can actually complement from it to become a better speaker. Everything. Not in Toastmasters, a lot of events that companies did, they need to know what went right and what went wrong. For the future purpose, although not everybody agree with the wrong, but that is the best that we can actually improve or implement from it. Now, for the table topic session, I'd like to invite the table topics evaluator and this chair to give a table topic evaluation on the vice chair.
Table topic master. If you're really trying to attend something new, you need to explain. Because in this case today, you give a name of a few famous guy and you give their code. Then only come the question. A lot of us do not catch you. So you need to explain that part first. That means first I'm going to say the famous code of this person, then followed by your title. Because you spend a lot of time to explain that. Second advice is, sorry, I first say a piece, now come two, okay? Is your question is a bit long. 2 minutes and let the person think on your feet and respond to your question, it has to be quite short, not so long, okay? I think you have two paragraph things, questions. All right. Today I realized suddenly we used to have 4 speakers for the table topic and we have promoted ourselves to 5 speakers. Give ourselves a clap of hands. And I would like to share with those speakers that will come up here, always think that you are number one. You are sharing something important with us. Don't feel agitated because you were command to stand here, you should take it as an opportunity for you to speak up. Alright? For speaker number one, Daryl. Senior speaker, national speaker, went for district contest, what else? Of course, we always give ourselves room for improvement. In your case, for your question on you love your job, okay? You say you love your job, and that's why you like to come to work every morning, and if you love your job, you will never work a day in your life, right? Okay. These are all very general statements. To emphasize or make your point stronger, it's best that you put some personal experience. Which part of the job you like most? And from that part of the job you like most, that translate the drive and the desire for you to continue doing year in, year out, not just 1 year, 2 years. Maybe 40, 50 years, you continue to do this thing because that is the part you like best about your job. Overall, you did quite well, except I think the closing part, maybe because you didn't put in your personal experience and pinpoint the specific factors or things that you like most about your job, so it makes your closing a bit weak. To impress the audience and catch the attention, it's good to have a very strong conclusion in that. Our second speaker is Nasir. If this is an acting class, I love your posture, you were like wow, a deep thinker and philosopher suddenly. Okay, I want to share with you that it's alright that you don't know the questions. Table topic session allow you to imagine and see something that it not necessarily be factual. It can be a story, or it can be a vision that you're going to have. But it's because you were given a question that, like, unforgettable mistake that you made in your career, which you just start. This is your first job, what? It's less than 6 months or so. How many mistakes you're going to make that, which is so unforgettable that you got to say out in this? So if you let your imagination run wild, you just imagine, if I make a mistake in my career, what would I do? So from there you can expand on, okay? For you to take on this challenge to come in front is something that I applaud you for that. Only thing that I would like to suggest one area, relax yourself when you come. Don't be so tense. Yes, you can start off with the posture like that, but don't take too long to do that. Because you're catching attention with that, but after quickly you've got to recompose your thought and put into speak. Ringgit. You're going to hear more from your evaluator later. Again, you are natural in your thought, but there are some habits that is good that you pick it up and take notice of it and remove that. Okay. When I say you're natural speakers, is that you can very easily convert the question and try and get the attention of the audience. Like for instance, if you are prime minister, straight away you are giving free food. These are the things, yes, people can connect to you very easily. And along with it, you also make it some joke. People even like to listen to you more with the kind of conversation that you throw up. All in all, it's good. You mention, you engage with the audience, you give your support with a few points, and you also conclude with your personal feeling that that part is good. Our fourth speaker, Wink. Never stop chasing my dream despite. I think it's very good of you to attempt and by asking questions, what does it mean despite? Okay. And I suggest that you use this so-called weakness because your vocabulary is not that wide. Some of the words you do not know about it. But if you can convert that into your strength by throwing that words to the audience, let the audience answer your questions, you know, instead of you ask for the answer, what is despite? You get me? This is what I say, using your weakness as your strength. Putting back as a question to the audience, let them help you with that. One area for improvement for you is actually is your posture. This is your trademark. Do you realize that? As you talk, you put your hand. Maybe it's through your training, years of training. It gives you a feeling of superior and you are in control when you're in a training room. Okay? But when you are doing a speech, it shows that you're on your own. You're not trying to connect to the audience. I mean, that kind of feelings I have. Okay? Another hand gesture of yours is grasping your two hands together. So be mindful about this too, otherwise overall, you can speak very naturally when you're given a question. Chris Hall. Good attempt. And I would like you to realize that tabletop session is a platform for you to release up something that you dare not even speak on the meeting day. Right? You know what I mean? You're forced to come to this. for you to speak your mind. You, what you dare not say in the meeting room or boardroom or any, even with your customer, this is the place that you talk and release it out. And by you saying it, that we can tell you your frustrations. Take my words. Now you take it as a chore. Just like how I started also. Coming to Toastmaster and doing all those things is a job. It's a job that I'm tasked to do it. I have to do it because everybody is looking at me and depend on me, especially the first year. I'm the chartered president for UPEC Toastmasters Club. I don't know anything and I learn from fresh. But I can very proud to share with you that I don't regret the I so-called suffer at that time, but now all this is become pleasure. If it is pleasure, pressure. I know the sales staff very stressed. I also very stressed out. So turning pressure into pleasure again, I enjoy this, like giving feedback, standing right in front of you. Also paying attention to what you speak in this Toastmaster meeting. So enjoy it. Don't take it as a pressure. That's all. Back to you.
Thank you, competent communicator Alice Chai. Wow, you have tremendously improved in your evaluation style. So please give Alice Chai a big round of applause.